a job. And you set out to do a job and you do the job. Live free or die. Or die trying.
Are you running for president?
Yes, I am. I will file the papers today to become an official candidate.
If he can get in the debates and if he can make a statement, I think it's a story that deserves to be told.
And I was the one the most hesitant to get involved.
We're going to have to engage in the Middle East. We have a new strategy.
Very confrontational and very aggressive.
There will be chaos that will spread to the region and to the rest of the world.
They ultimately want to bring down the United States of America.
Just come home. We just marched in.
And I said to myself, what is he doing up on stage with all of these other Republican candidates?
I would ask the congressman to withdraw that comment and tell us that he didn't really mean that.
This is just going to shake the establishment. They do not want this guy running for president.
The media are almost incapable of reporting and even understanding the Constitution.
We had to become our own media.
The new free press was utilized, the internet.
The community of websites that was created is really quite phenomenal. It's like its own world.
We're not going to do things the normal way.
I think the blimp has got to stand out in everybody's mind. I mean, that was just such an outrageous thing to do.
We were very impressed at how quickly a seemingly random group of people could pull together this rather unusual, unique project.
I would like to tell the grassroots that whether your ideas were very logical or very insane.
You've heard of highway blogging? This is ski blogging.
They were always inspiring and sometimes amusing.
One small step for man, one giant leap for Ron Paul.
There were more Ron Paul signs than anything else everywhere.
It's not just what kind of places, it's like, can you attach it?
You got a permit to put that sign up? Never even crossed their mind. Didn't even blaze over their cortex, brush it at all, that they were going to seek some kind of permission from the man to challenge the man.
They were so passionate that they just gave everything.
He was raising about $200,000 every half hour or so.
And then we held a consecutive money bomb December 16th, which was the anniversary of the Boston Tea Party.
At the height of the march, there had to be 15,000 people there.
Certainly was an act of defiance to choose an arena just on the opposite side of town. The national convention is going on.
The difference between free thinkers and ditto heads. And that's the difference between the Rally for the Republic and the RNC.
It was the culmination of everything that his whole campaign stood for.
Let it not be said that we did nothing.
I wrote about one of the first times people tried to mess with the Ron Paul movement. It was in Iowa when there was a candidates forum being put on by the Iowa Christian Alliance and the Iowans for Tax Reform. They didn't want to let Ron Paul participate. They let Tommy Thompson participate. At the last minute, they invited Jim Gilmore, who is not Pink Floyd's guitarist, by the way. No one even knows who Jim Gilmore is.
Ron Paul's been long said to be the taxpayer's best friend. I don't think he's ever voted to increase taxes once, because he doesn't think there should be any, no income tax in particular.
You know, it would be like not inviting Batman to your convention against the Riddler. You know, how could you not invite Ron Paul to this?
When Ron Paul was excluded, we were like, well, what do we want to do? And we started talking, and we were like, well, let's hold a rally outside, and everybody was talking about just going up there and protesting.
So the Ron Paul people decided they were going to have their own event in the next room.
A lot of times campaigns are centered around the individual, and the individual starts it and rallies the troops. But the truth is, the people who are interested in sound government, limited government, the Constitution, are really the organizers.
That was one of the big first rallies with like 1,000 people.
They ended up getting twice as many people at their event, which was much more interesting. There was no propaganda in it. It was all real information.
We now live in an age, now for a good many years, way too many years, that the federal government owns all our income and we're permitted to keep a certain percentage. That is the terrible notion of the personal income tax, which we should get rid of.
And here's Ron Paul, by the way. You know, he wants to abolish the IRS and replace it with nothing. Well, yeah, I can understand why you wouldn't want to have him at your candidate's forum.
The only way for this to work is grassroots support. It's spontaneous.
I've been involved in startups before. My background is starting a hospital software company. So you understand the power of organization. But what I hadn't really experienced in my life was the power of spontaneous order, where people see a shared vision. They come from all different political philosophies, all different life experiences, but there's a shared vision of what it means to be Americans and to have a country that follows the rules. And things just started coming together.